Hello everyone, welcome to the Stock Trading Tutor channel. In this video, we'll be looking at the weighted moving average. So we'll see some slides, a presentation of with some explanation, and I'll show you some screenshots of the weighted moving average so we can see how it actually applies on the chart itself. So first, what is a moving average? So moving averages are favored tools of active traders to measure momentum. A simple moving average, so the formula is given, is the sum of the data points over a given period divided by the number of periods. So a 5-period moving average based on the prices will be calculated as given. So we have the 5 separate prices and divided by the number of period. So here is how a simple moving average would look on a candlestick chart. So we have the Nifty 50 index here, and this is, we have applied the 10 period moving average on the closing price. So this is a 1 hour candlestick. So when we apply the moving average, 10 period moving average onto the candlestick chart, so we'll see how the moving average moves so close to the candlestick chart. So this is the simple moving average. Now let's see the weighted moving average. So weighted moving averages assign a heavier weighting to more current data points since they are more relevant than data points in the distant past. So the sum of the weighting should add up to 1 or 100%. In the case of simple moving averages, the weightings are equally distributed. The weighted moving average places more emphasis on recent prices than on older prices. So each period's data is multiplied by a weight, with the weighting determined by the number of periods selected. So let me show you an example comparison to the moving average and the weighted moving average. So the blue line is the simple moving average and the red line is the weighted moving average. So you can see how it's moving a bit closer to the candlestick chart. So both are 50 period moving averages, and the blue line doesn't react to the market changes as closely as the weighted moving average does. So we can see it's a little bit faster in movement as it's giving more weightage to the recent prices. So here's the formula for calculating the weighted moving average. So we have price into weighting factor plus the price of the previous period into the weighting factor minus 1. So like that, once we apply it, we have the formula given here. And then where n is the time period. So if we put it in an example, so we have the weighted moving average formula and how it would look once we apply it on a equation. So the recent data points was given the highest weighting out of the arbitrary 5 points. So here we have 5 points. So here we have the weightage of the 15 points. So 5 by 15 plus 4 by 15 plus 3 by 15, 2 by 15 and 1 by 15. So that is how we apply it. So you can weigh the values out of any value you see fit. Out of the 15 points, we have the n here. So the lower value from the weighted average above relative to the simple average suggests that the recent selling price could be more significant than the some traders anticipate. So for most traders, the most popular choice when using weighted moving average is to use a higher weighting for recent values. So that is what we have done. This is the more recent value, so this has a higher weight in comparison to the rest of it, thus giving us the weighted moving average here. Next, let's look at. So using the weighted moving average, you can determine the trend direction. So this can be an indication to buy when the prices dip near or just below the weighted moving average. So it could be an indication to sell when the prices rally towards or just above the weighted moving average. So when it crosses the moving average, the candlestick, you can use that as a indication. So indication to buy when the prices dip near or just below the weighted moving average. So here is a selling point here. we can see. So we've actually applied two weighted moving averages on this specific candlestick chart. So the red line is the 12 period moving average, and the blue line is the 144 period moving average. So this is a combination, and once you apply it to the chart, you can see the direction in which the candlestick is moving. So we can see generally that the candlestick is moving here. In these places, we can see the candlestick is moving up and down over the, in this specific place here. We can see both of them are, the candlestick chart is above both of the moving average lines. So this is definitely a bullish trend. So here again, when the smaller period moving averages moves above the longer period, this is a bullish trend. So here we are seeing this specific point, we are seeing a bearish trend at the end of the chart here, close to the right hand side, the end of the chart. This here is a bearish trend, and here we have the bullish trend in this corner. So that's how we determine the, we can use one way to determine the weighted moving average. So you can use combinations of two separate time periods to get an idea of how the weighted moving average, and use it for creating signals. Along with the weighted moving average, you're also welcome to use other indicators so that you can get confirmation of the signal. So the weighted moving average is generally more sensitive to price movement. This can be a double-edged sword. On one side, the weighted moving average can identify trends sooner than the simple moving average. On the flip side, the weighted moving average will probably experience more whipsaws than the corresponding simple moving average. So let's look at a chart here to give you an example. So the green line is the weighted moving average, which is experiencing more whipsaws than the simple moving average. And since the weighted moving average is more sensitive to the price movement, turning up earlier than the simple moving average. So when there's a volatile market, the weighted moving average will move along with the chart a bit closer than the simple moving average, and this is possible. It can give you some false signals. So as we have here also, as we can see, we thought it might cross and go into the bearish signal, but however, it flipped up because it's closer to the moving average time period. So these are examples of how you should be a little bit more careful while you're using the weighted moving average. Along with this, you can always use a combination of indicators so that you get proper confirmation of the signals, buy and sell signals. So thank you for watching this video. For more videos on stock market and trading, please subscribe to this channel.